granduncle bought it brand new.
Really?
It's the Batmobile! It's the real Batmobile! Yo, Commissioner Gordon, what we got? Where the Joker at?
Caffeine and Octane in Jacksonville, guys.
I like it.
Me too.
Yeah, it's neat. Either one of you take my lead and come down early to check out some of the car culture?
I wanted to, but some of us don't have the liberty of being retired like you.
Yeah, I have kids.
Me too.
What I did get to do was I got to draw on a car. There's an artist here. He's actually got some cars out here where he literally like covers the car in art.
Someone let you draw on a car?
Hey, you don't trust my skills?
Yes, they did.
I really like just all kinds of colors. I just started throwing them different ways and dripping them into each other, and it started catching on.
There you go. Now you're getting a little hot rod in there. Who do you feel like are your usual car clients?
There's someone that's just a little bit out there.
I think I saw those cars this morning when I was coming in. They got a bunch of graffiti all over the car.
Yeah, right,
that's,
over
what, that's what you're talking about,
yeah,
right?
Yeah,
I
right
can't
here.
Believe somebody's letting you draw on their car.
You have no faith.
Okay, you know you're starting to get older when trends like band shoes start to come back into style. The haircuts have come back. And oh no! We've got the Roadster! Woo-hoo. Welcome to Caffeine and Octane Jacksonville, people. We're in Florida.
There's car clubs down this way. The exotics are over this way. Over here, you have more of the vintage cars. Look at this. It's a Saratoga. 39,000 original miles?
39,000, one family owner. Because my granduncle bought it brand new. Used it for a year, and then bought a 1960 Chrysler and garaged this.
Wow.
So it has really been a true Sunday driver its whole life. It's a 1959 Chrysler Saratoga. I bought it from my granduncle probably about 20 years ago. He goes, all right, you can finally have it. You pay me what I bought it for, $3,400. This is a true original car. Nothing's been done to it.
And the condition, the patina, the stainless and aluminum chrome is all in just amazing shape. The liner in the trunk, this stuff, the cardboard in here, these fell apart pretty easy. You got into an area where there's a lot of moisture, it just disintegrated.
Yeah, he kept it covered with blankets, cardboard.
Oh, is that right?
Oh, yes.
Wow.
Yeah, he babied it.
On the interior of these, you look at this, and getting this interior to duplicate it would be nearly impossible today. Yeah, I love the way they put the rearview mirror on the padded dashboard. The swing-out seats.
When Chrysler came out, they were designed as a ladies' car. So to be a true lady in the 50s, you had to always be prim and proper. Well, to come out of a car, you couldn't really do that. So what they did was they made the swivel seats for a lady to be a true lady. She could swivel out with her legs crossed, and that way it made it nice and convenient for them to get out of the car.
I can't thank you enough for bringing this out today.
Anytime,
this
Skip.
Is really, really a treat to see something. It's basically a time capsule from 1959. That's terrific. You've done a beautiful job of carrying part.
Well, thank you, bud. Appreciate it. Let's talk about stance. All you people with Teslas out there, why doesn't it sit like